Back in 2020, we released an episode of Talking Pictures that looked at Union's steamship company excursions to Fiordland. In it, we touched upon some of the artists and photographers who went along on some of these voyages. Having just been on a trip to film in Preservation and Chalky Inlets ourselves, I thought for this latest episode we'd take a closer look at one of those early photographers and some of the images he brought back from this remote corner of New Zealand. Alfred Henry Burton was the eldest of four sons of printer and photographer John Burton of Leicester. He, his wife Lydia, and their first child Una Emma arrived in Dunedin in 1868. Alfred had come to join the photography business recently established by his younger brother Walter, and the business now became known as Burton Brothers. While Walter focused on portrait photography, Alfred became known for his landscape photography, travelling widely to capture New Zealand's beauty spots. One day in March 1874, Judge Bathgate called Burton Brothers' studio with a proposition. The government paddle steamer Luna was in town. It was due to depart on a voyage to the West Coast Sounds that very afternoon, and the judge wanted to know if Alfred Burton wished to tag along and bring his camera. Alfred didn't hesitate in accepting the offer, quickly packed his bags, and off he went. The first stop was Codfish Island off Stewart Island. He took his first photographs there, but then some of the younger passengers took to lighting fires in the bush, creating a smoke screen that spoiled his shots. Next, the group spent one night in Preservation Inlet before moving on to Chalky Inlet, and then here to Dusky Sound, where Alfred obtained a few shots before the typical West Coast rain set in. The same thing happened in Doubtful Sound. Alfred had convinced the captain of the Luna to leave him and a boat's crew on an islet and call back to pick him up later. But as soon as the Luna was out of sight, the heavens broke open. The shore party sheltered in the hollow trunk of a massive tree and lit a fire. After they'd been picked up and were several miles away from the islet, Alfred discovered he had left one of his lenses behind and had a job persuading the captain to turn around and go back for it. Alfred had hoped to be the first photographer to capture images of Milford Sound on this trip, but to his dismay, halfway up the sound, they came across a schooner with a photographer from the old country on board. Thus, Alfred had to settle for second place and be content with being the first colonial photographer to expose a plate in Milford Sound. And for Alfred Burton, this was the first of many expeditions to the Sounds. By 1898, he claimed to have either been on trips to the Sounds himself or at least sent someone in his place more than 20 times. His second visit was in 1879, when he travelled on the Union Steamship Company steamer Rotorua. Walter Burton had left the Burton Brothers partnership in 1877. He was briefly replaced by another brother, John William, who appears to have accompanied Alfred on the January 1879 voyage of the Rotorua. Walter, meanwhile, set up a new studio of his own in Dunedin late in 1878. But the business didn't prosper, and in 1880 he committed suicide. Alfred Burton's third trip was in December 1879, and his fourth in February 1882. The fourth was a little different to the previous ones. He purchased a ticket on the Union Steamship Company steamer Rotamahana, bound for Melbourne via Milford Sound. At Milford Sound, he got off and spent the next 3 weeks photographing in and around the Sound, before being collected by a different Union Steamship Company steamer on the return route from Melbourne to Port Chalmers. Burton was guided round the Sound by local resident Donald Sutherland, who had promised to show him all the best spots, including the spectacular Sutherland Falls, the tallest waterfall in New Zealand. However, it wasn't until 6.5 years later, in October 1888, that Burton brothers managed to produce the first photo of the falls in their entirety. In 1884, Alfred Burton made yet another trip to the Sounds. Rival Dunedin photographer Frank Coxhead was also aboard the Tarawera as it left Port Chalmers, making what is thought to be his first trip to take pictures in the Sounds. Burton and his assistant were dropped in Dusky Sound, while Coxhead was dropped further up the coast in Milford Sound, where he, like Burton before him, was shown around by Donald Sutherland. About 10 days or so after having dropped Burton and his assistant in Dusky Sound, the Tarawera, with a second load of excursionists, was back to pick them up. Before they continued on their journey, the Tarawera's passengers did a spot of hunting, fishing, exploring, and had their photos taken on the shore of Wet Jacket Arm. Someone then came up with the idea of holding a regatta, and £40 were collected to be used as prize money. 6 races were run, the highlight being the sailors versus the stewards. The stewards took an early lead, but the sailors won out in the end. Alfred Burton awarded extra prizes to the competitors in the ladies' race. The winning crew members were allowed to select 6 large photos each from Burton Brothers' shop when they got back to Dunedin, while the women in the losing boat were allowed to select 3 photos each. Then it was off to the Sounds further north, not forgetting, of course, to collect Frank Coxhead from Milford. Perhaps we can look at more of Coxhead's photography in a later episode. But for now, that's a wrap. See you next time, and thanks for watching.